One, two. Bass Judy, you're closing. 13 years. It's been 13 years. It has been 13 years. It's kind of a long time. Okay. Yes, it's true. After 13 years in existence since 2010, Janek's Bass Studio is closing its doors. It's really the end of an era, and not something to be sad about. It's something quite overwhelming in a certain sense, because it's been so long, it's been so much work, it's been a labor of love. It's over 1,000 videos, it's sheet music, it's transcriptions, it's the live archive, it's so many things. Most importantly, it's all of you. It's all of the people that have been involved since 2010. Some people still involved in the site from way back then. That's the overwhelming element of it. But the reason for the closing is very freeing, and it's an amazing step forward for me in terms of freeing up time to do the things that bring me most joy in my life. That's the underlying factor to all of this, and I want to share a little bit of that story, how I got here, and of course where I'm going and what's next. I don't think you have to look very far to see that the subscription model of learning, of being online, basically, is everywhere in our lives. We all have tons of subscriptions, some of which we've completely forgotten about, some of which we use literally every hour of every day. Everything from Spotify and perhaps YouTube Premium to, you know, luxuries like masterclass.com. I actually was trying to do some research for this video, and it was so deep when I got to masterclass.com that I had to pull it up on my phone so I didn't forget some of the insane people they have managed to get just in their music category of education. I'm looking here at Metallica, Yo-Yo Ma, Ringo Starr, Mariah Carey, John Legend, Questlove, Danny Elfman, Hans Zimmer, Sheila E., Itzhak Perlman, Timbaland, Carlos Santana, Herbie Hancock, Reba McEntire, Christina Aguilera. I mean, the list is endless. I have no idea the exact structure behind the scenes of masterclass.com, but I can only begin to imagine the team, the financing, and all of the business acumen that must go into creating such a product, especially when you consider they're able to deliver all of that and way more. Don't forget the Gordon Ramsays, the Ron Howards, that just every category. You can take a tennis lesson with Serena Williams. I mean, it's an insane depth of education. They can deliver all of that for $10 a month. So when I look at my own very small corner of an already very small niche, let's face it, here in the bass world, it's quite a compact community. There's not a lot of space to kind of move around. And when you've got, you know, the likes of SBL, Scott's Bass Lessons, again, not that dissimilar from masterclass.com. They've done all the right things business-wise. They've hired a huge team. They have leveled up. They've expanded. Similar to masterclass.com, I don't know their behind-the-scenes thing, but I do know they are moving towards that sort of level here in our small bass community. So when I look at my own thing, I realize that the amount of time I am able to commit to it as an individual, literally doing everything on my own, versus what I'm able to charge realistically in the marketplace, and then of course in turn what I'm able to bring in as a reasonable profit from this venture. Let's just say things have changed a lot in the past 13 years, and that dynamic no longer makes any sense with what I want to do with my life and with my career. So much like the last video, if you saw that posted just a few days ago about getting rid of my bases and reducing the clutter in my immediate physical space, I'm doing the same with my career, with my music, and with my schedule, with what I have to do every day. And like I said, this could be looked at as a bit of a sad moment, 13 years of work and blah, 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 but it's actually a really positive first foot forward in the right direction for kind of a new chapter in my career. And just before we move on to what's next, the bigger picture in my life and in my career and in my music, I just want to say that what we're doing with the Bass Studio is it's not being erased. I'm not just deleting the entire thing. If you are a current member or you've purchased courses there, you are going to have access to that forever. I'll always keep it up. What we're doing is just closing the door to the subscription model. So no more monthly, no more annual, no more lifetime memberships. As of Sunday at midnight, as of this week, the posting of this video, we are closing the doors to subscriptions. They are just too much work versus the reward when it comes to the overall running of the business. So if you do want to be a part of it, we are taking a few more members before we close the door on Sunday night. There are discount codes linked in the description of this video for lifetime and annual membership. After that, that's it. We're closing the doors, and it's going to give me the opportunity to service the members that want to stay on behind the closed doors way better than I've been able to in the recent past. So let's talk a little bit about the future and where that leaves my kind of teaching side of the career path I have right now. Of course, I'm going to keep writing the books. I love doing those. I plan on doing one or two a year. It's nice to have a standalone project. It's kind of a big thing. I can research, write, and then go into production and put it out there. And then it sort of runs itself after the fact, after the release. And I'm going to be able to do something now that I haven't been able to do in many, many years, which is private lessons. I've always told people who have emailed and got in contact saying, hey, do you teach privately? Can I take a lesson? Can I do it on a video call, FaceTime, Skype, or something? I've always said, and it's been really an honest statement up until this point, I've always said, look, my schedule is just far too crazy to do anything like this. Until recently, I've been touring 5, 6, 7 months of the year. Now the focus is way more on the family and on spending more time at home and not being on the road for months on end. So I'm actually able to work in some hours every week to commit to teaching. It's something I actually love to do. I love to meet people one-on-one, but until now I haven't had the time to do it. So I'm going to start opening up time slots. They'll be available at my website. They're all linked below. And I'm going to open up a few time slots a week because I do have the time now. Really pretty excited about that. And I think I can do a lot more for the people who want something specifically from me, rather than with the bass studio trying to compete with the beginner, the weekender, the people who want like maybe just a little bit of quick information. That was never my thing. It was always about the reality of the music business, the reality of my career, the reality of being a great fundamental musician and player and how to achieve that through hard work. And I know that wasn't a mass appeal subject for people, but the people who really actually want a little bit of that specific information, who are perhaps considering going to music school, perhaps considering really becoming a professional musician, professional bass player, those are the people I can dedicate a little bit more time to now. Now, rebalancing the teaching element of my life is just one part of what I'm moving forwards to. I'm also going quite old school with my blog, with my mailing list. I'm sending an email a day, every morning, 8 a.m. Pacific time, and I'm sharing a live song, a live bootleg, a live track for everything from D'Angelo to Sting to Clifford Brown to Charlie Parker. My archive is pretty deep. It's literally millions of songs, a majority of which are live bootleg concerts that I've collected over the years. Also some that I've been to and recorded myself, just capturing live moments and using them to learn. It's not just about sitting there and listening to music. I like to share my process. I write a little post about what it means to me, how I connected with that music, and how I'm using some of that information to absorb into my practice routine and into my playing. So that is linked below, janekgwizdala.substack.com. It's completely free. Just sign up with your email address and you get an email every day. Just connecting with music is the real aim of the mailing list now. And it's just one of the many projects I'm working on moving forwards here with the extra time I'm afforded by not running this massive part of my business that has kind of taken up a huge part of my life for well over a decade now. And let's finish up here with what I consider to be the pinnacle, the most important thing in my musical life. And that is, guess what? It's music. It's making music. It's why I got into this in the first place. It's why I continue to get out of bed. It's why I have unlimited amounts of willpower to work on the art form every day of the week. The commitment I'm making to myself, and I guess to you, the fans, the listeners, is to create one kind of mega project every year. Last year, we traveled to Spain to make One Way Out. In just 6 weeks from now, we are heading to Argentina for this year's mega project. And that's how I want it to continue. I want to make sure I'm making at least one big album every year, playing some concerts, getting involved with the audience, and of course, growing the audience, playing in countries I haven't even traveled to before, never mind played. So really kind of returning to making the music, not only the centerpiece, but making it really special again. I consider what we did last year in Spain with One Way Out to be incredibly successful on a personal level, because it was the first time in my entire 20-year recording career that I broke even on a project. All of these projects have been self-funded. They've been without a label, without management, without booking, without any of that kind of traditional format. But this was the first time I involved the audience before we did the recording. I did a pre-sale for the album, much like I'm doing right now for the new recording in Argentina. And by the time the album came out last year, it had actually broken even. So the plan is never to make money from that side of things. The plan is for it not to cost a fortune to create the music and get it out there for you to listen to. So to that end, the same thing is happening this year. The pre-sale is happening now. It's linked below. And it really is, this is what brings me joy. This is the biggest part of closing down the bass studio. It's the biggest part of, you know, stripping away all the instruments I haven't played in years and years. And this is going to continue because it allows me to focus so much more time on creating music, on actually doing the thing I got into all of this for in the first place. And I couldn't do any of it without all of you, without everyone watching this video, without everyone, you know, downloading the music and streaming the music on Spotify and just generally supporting the cause for all of these years. So thank you for that and appreciate you watching. See you on the next one.